After launching the A340, Airbus looked at increasing the capacity and range of its -300 variant. Wanting to build an A340 with an ultra-long range, the company then developed the A340-500, which would be powered by four Rolls-Royce Trent 500 engines. Its theoretical maximum range, close to 9,000 nautical miles. Compared to its predecessor, the -500 was just over 13 feet longer, boosting its passenger capacity. The aircraft type was Airbus's first ultra-long-range aircraft and was indeed deployed in this manner with certain airlines. Emirates sent it from Dubai to New York, while Singapore Airlines used it to operate the longest flight in the world, from Singapore to New York. In today's video, we take a deep dive into the history of this Airbus quadjet. Under the command of Airbus chief test pilot Jacques Rosset, the A340-500 made its maiden flight on February 11, 2002. Following more tests, the plane received its airworthiness certification on December 3, 2002, and was due to enter service with Air Canada in the new year. Air Canada, however, had entered into financial difficulties and was forced to file for bankruptcy protection. Dubai-based carrier Emirates stepped in to become the launch customer for the variant. As mentioned at the start of this video, it deployed the jet on long flights from Dubai, such as to New York, but also Melbourne, Auckland, and Sydney. Air Canada would eventually use the plane on its Toronto-Hong Kong service. To achieve its ultra-long-range capability, Airbus had to modify the A340 to accommodate more fuel tanks and larger wings. Impressively, the plane could carry 50% more fuel than the A340-300. Singapore Airlines took great advantage of the A340-500, operating the first modern ultra-long-haul routes using the aircraft. The variant was initially used by the airline to fly from Singapore to Los Angeles. However, it would also open the door to the current longest flight in the world, Singapore to New York. The first Singapore-Newark service took place in June 2004, flying over 15,300 kilometers between the two cities. This equated to nearly 8,300 nautical miles. The 18-hour journey was flown with a premium heavy configuration, featuring 64 business class seats and 117 in executive economy, akin to premium economy. The plane later featured a 100-seat all business class cabin. One morbid yet strangely interesting feature on the Singapore Airlines aircraft was the existence of a compartment to store dead bodies. The length of the carrier's Singapore-Newark flights led it to think carefully about how it would handle medical emergencies on such long services. Indeed, such routes included a significant share of time flying over the Pacific Ocean, translating into fewer opportunities to divert. The airline devised a rather unusual solution to handle the rare instance of a passenger dying on board, installing a corpse cupboard on board its A340-500. This was a discreet locker next to one of the aircraft's exit doors to hold an average-sized human body. Special straps were also provided to secure the body and prevent it from being moved by turbulence or during landing. These would only be used as a last resort, in a scenario where no free rows of seats were available in the cabin to lay out the deceased person and cover their body. However, according to an airline spokesman, the compartment was likely never used. The A340-500 was never a popular aircraft. This was because of its very niche role, which meant that the market for the type was minimal. Ultra-long-haul flying is incredibly hard to make work in the best of times with low fuel prices and a strong economy. Rising fuel prices and four gas-guzzling engines only make things worse. In terms of sales to commercial passenger carriers, Emirates led the way with 10. Singapore Airlines had 5, Etihad and Thai Airways each had 4. A few more airlines, including Air Canada and Azerbaijan Airlines, had fleets that included two A340-500 airframes. While the new ultra-long routes were record-breaking, Singapore Airlines would eventually go on to pull the plug on the Newark service in early 2013, citing a lack of revenue. Yes, the A340-500 was ideal for ETOPS requirements, but things had changed greatly between the aircraft's design and its early years of service. In 1990, Boeing convinced the FAA that it could deliver a safe twin-engine aircraft that could adhere to the then 180-minute ETOPS rules. The FAA required the new Boeing 777 to demonstrate 1 year of safe ETOPS 120-minute operations before being given the green light for ETOPS 180. Having passed the test, Boeing introduced the Boeing 777-200LR in 2006. With superior fuel efficiency and a range rivaling Airbus's offering, airlines lost their enthusiasm for the A340-500. According to Flight Global, Emirates President Sir Tim Clark was quoted in 2013 as saying, "We've taken a big hit to retire them, but their poor economics means there's no point in flying them." In 2011, Airbus announced that it was stopping production of the A340 and would look to build a new long-range twin-engine plane, which we now know as the Airbus A350. And so, what is the state of the A340-500 in mid-2024? Well, many of the A340-500's operators retired the aircraft years ago. The last airline to use it as a commercial passenger aircraft was Azerbaijan Airlines. The A340-500 as a passenger jet has been in limbo for the past few years. There's been no official retirement announcement by Azerbaijan Airlines for its two jets. Rather, the aircraft have simply been parked and stored for an extended period of time, denying us a sense of finality for A340-500 passenger flights. Could these aircraft be reactivated for passenger flights one day? In theory, yes. But the likelihood of this happening is low. However, assuming that this pair of jets are never used for regular flights again, then the very last commercial flight for the A340-500 would have been on March 8, 2023. Flight Radar 24 shows it flew between Baku and Adana in Turkey. In terms of active -500s, Planespotters.net notes that jets continue to fly for several governments as VIP transport. Countries include Algeria, Kuwait, Qatar, Thailand, and Turkey. Outside of this, one airframe belonging to the Las Vegas Sands Corporation also seems to be active. So, that's the history of Airbus's first ultra-long-range aircraft. Its extensive range opened up city pairs that were previously unthinkable. However, this was only made possible through high rates of fuel consumption, leading to the jet's lack of popularity, particularly after the emergence of the Boeing 777-200LR. These days, the A350-900ULR could be seen as the spiritual successor to the A340-500. Like its four-engined counterpart, the A350-900ULR is used by Singapore Airlines on the world's longest flight between Singapore and New York. And again, like the A340-500s used by the airline in the past, these jets fly lighter with fewer passengers and a premium-only configuration. So what are your thoughts on the A340-500? Did you ever get a chance to fly on one? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.